Welcome to Ryan's Tech, guys. I'm going to share some nice tips and tricks for the new Epix Pro Watch, from simple to advanced, which should work on the new Fenix 7 Pro as well, at least most of them. And please save this video in a playlist to keep as a reference for the future. Starting with number one, and this is something I only learned as I'm making this video. In the review video, I wasn't really sure if this is an actual feature of this watch, but here it is. This watch comes with an audio prompt feature. I use by wearing my earbuds during activities, and the prompt can announce you different things, but you can customize this or disable it. Press the start stop button, then go to the settings, then audio prompts. Here you can customize everything from the accent of the voice prompt to what things it should say. Just play around and do a test run and find out which ones are the most important to you. This way, you might not necessarily need to constantly check your watch to check your stats. For example, you can change the alert frequency from lap to a time interval. All right, number two. By default, the watch assumes you're wearing it on your left wrist. If you want to wear it on your right wrist, don't forget to change this in the settings to get the most accurate readings. To do that, go to the settings, and from now, I'll just say go to the settings, as you already know where to find it. Then user profile, then scroll all the way down to wrist and change it to right. Number three, if you want to use a treadmill or a stationary bike or something else, then if that device is not very old, it most likely can't connect to your watch to show your heart rate on it directly. So to do that, you need to broadcast the HR from your watch. So in the settings, swipe up all the way until you find the health and wellness, then go to heart rate, and at the bottom choose broadcast heart rate, and then press start. Number four, in the heart rate settings, you can also enable abnormal heart rate alerts. Just go to the menu with the same name and enable high, low, or both, and you can adjust the threshold as well. But if you're a professional athlete, your heart rate can go below 40, for example, during sleep. So you might want to keep that off. Number five, by default, your watch doesn't show the battery percentage on the glance view, but it does show on the activities and apps menu. So if you like to see that in the glance view too, go to the settings, then power manager, and then turn on the battery percentage. Number six, if you don't like the order of the way things are organized in the glance view, just tap and hold on any of the options there and reorder or remove them entirely. You can even add new ones here. Number seven, there's a feature called Jet Lag Advisor, and it really does what it sounds like. It basically helps you reduce the effects of jet lag, so do the following steps to use it when you're traveling. First, go to the glance view by swiping up or down or pressing the up or down buttons, then tap and hold on any of the glances like before, and go to the Add Glance. Then find Jet Lag Advisor and add it to the glances. Then go to the Garmin Connect app, then in the menu, expand the training and planning, and go to Jet Lag Advisor. Here you can plan your future trips. After that, sync the app with your watch, then go back to the Jet Lag Advisor glance to get personalized advice about your trip. Number eight, this watch has a stress management feature, which is great. But there is another stress test called HRV stress that is very useful to take right before any training or workout sessions. But there is a catch here. To be able to run this test, you need to have a heart rate chest strap on. And to do it, press the start stop button, then keep swiping up, then press the plus button, then add, then HRV stress. Now wear your chest strap, then stand up. Yes, you have to stand up for this specific test, then start it, and it'll take 3 minutes to run. Here's a screenshot of a test that I ran before my training session. This stress level ranges from 1 to 100. The lower it is, the more ready you are for a tough workout. Number nine, how to connect a heart rate chest strap to this watch? Well, the heart rate monitors don't have any power buttons. You just need to wear them and they start broadcasting. So just go to the settings, then sensors and accessories, then add new, then search all sensors. After that, anytime you wear your chest strap, it'll automatically connect to your watch. Number 10, how to run a health snapshot. If this is your first Garmin watch, Health Snapshot is a kind of test that takes 2 minutes to run, and you can get a report that includes your stress, blood oxygen saturation, respiration rate, average HR, and HRV. The best way to do this is to do it around the same time and under the same conditions every day. For example, in the morning, as soon as you wake up, or before you go to bed, or both. but the watch only shows you the RMS SD value. If you want to know the SDRR value, you have to look at your report in the Garmin Connect app itself. And if you want to know what those two really mean, on the health snapshot report, tap the three dots and go to help, then heart rate variability. Number 11, your watch has great reliable sensors, but there is a way to make things even more accurate. By default, Garmin watches use something called smart data recording. But if you absolutely want to have the most detailed and accurate values, then you can change that. Just go to the settings, then all the way down, go to system, then data recording, and change that to every second. Just bear in mind that this will use more battery than the smart one. And another disclaimer here is that if you choose the every second data recording, then the watch might not record the entirety of a longer activity or training session. So it's best for shorter activities to get a more detailed recording. Number 12. So this tip is one of those advanced ones that even many pros don't know about. So by now we know that the Apex Pro measures the HRV during sleep to get an HRV status that we can check out right in the health folder of the glass view. We can take a snapshot and measure our HRV for 2 minutes. And finally, we can measure our HRV stress with a 3-minute test by using heart rate monitor. But there is no way of measuring our HRV during activities, right? Well, I'm going to share with you an unknown and secret way of doing it that Garmin hasn't even advertised, and you can't find any information about it anywhere. But again, there is a catch. You will need a chest strap. First of all, that's the only reliable way of measuring the HRV during an activity, and second of all, this feature won't work without a heart rate monitor anyways. All you have to do is to go to the settings, then system from down below, and then again data recording, and finally turn on log HRV. Now wear your chest strap and do your activity. Once it's done, unfortunately you can't directly see this data on the Garmin Connect app, and definitely not on the watch itself. Currently, the only way of seeing your activity HRV stats that I know of is to use third-party providers. The one that I use is a software called Kubias HRV. They have a mobile app and a desktop app, which is the one that I use, and they have a scientific version, which is paid and is very expensive, and a free version. The free version is what you need. After installing it, connect your watch to your computer, and then in the Garmin folder, go to the activity folder. Basically, every time you do an activity, your watch stores that data in a file with a format called .fit. Just find the right timestamp for your activity and open that file with that software. Then you're going to see a medical-like report of HRV, which is pretty cool. And you can even export PDF and CSV files. Let me know in the comments, or like the video, or both, if you're finding this video useful so far. All right, number 13, how to customize the controls menu. Go to the settings, then appearance, then controls. Go all the way down to add new, find what you need, then tap plus or press the start-stop button. A faster way of doing it is to press and hold the light button, then tap and hold any of the controls, then either add controls, reorder, or remove them right from here directly. Number 14, you can double press the light button to turn on the flashlight, but if you want to change its intensity or color, then you should go to the controls menu and select the flashlight. Number 15, in the controls menu, find strobe, and if it's not there, just add to the menu using the tip you just learned. Now, in addition to the four presets, you can customize it. So select custom, then press the start stop button, then choose one of the four modes, change the speed and color. Number 16, by default during activities, the touch control is disabled. To enable it, go to the settings, then system, and then touch, then during activity, and turn it on. You can even choose map only. Number 17, this watch has a feature called redshift that turns everything into red color. And you might think it's just an on-off switch, but actually you can customize it when to change to redshift. So again, in the settings, go to system, then display, and here you can choose whether you want to turn on the redshift during an activity or during sleep or right away for general use. Number 18, the Apex Pro allows you to have a sleep schedule for each day of the week separately. In the settings, go to the system, then sleep mode, then schedule. This should be perfect for those of you who do shift work. Number 19, During sleep, the watch face changes to sleep watch face automatically. If you don't like that and want to have your current one, then in the same place as before, instead of sleep schedule, go to watch face and select don't change. Number 20. Now that we're in the system settings, I want to show you how you can set up shortcuts on your watch. And trust me, having shortcuts is a necessity. So in the system settings, go to hotkeys and customize each one of them for maximum efficiency. Number 21, how to extend the battery life in smartwatch mode without turning off any features. All you have to do is to stop wearing the watch and instead put it in your pocket and only look at the time when you really need it. I'm just kidding, guys. Press and hold the up button, then go to the watch face, press the start button, then go to the accent color and data color and choose a grayscale color. By limiting the colors that are used, your watch will use less battery. Of course, the alternative is to use the redshift, but that may not be very pleasant to use for everyone and every situation. Number 22, Garmin Connect IQ Store is the name of the app that you can install on your phone to install different apps and watch faces onto your watch. But with Epix Pro, you can use the IQ Store directly on your watch and install what you need. Press the start stop button, then swipe up to find Connect IQ Store. And if you want to use the Garmin Connect app like a pro, watch this video next.